In a system that can be imagined. He says, no, you must have a certain mental picture. So that gave me an idea. I said, yes, maybe you have. I said, when you pray, how do you pray? And I answered for him. See, I'm posing the question. When you pray, how do you pray? I said, you pray like this, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Ghost. Right? He said, right. I said, when you say in the name of the Father, you are thinking of old Father Christmas sitting on some planet with his feet dangling onto the earth at his footstool and the heaven as his canopy. And this is all biblical from the Bible. All this thing I'm quoting, I'm only taking from their language. The wordings are all from there. The heaven is his canopy, the earth is his footstool, the heaven millions and millions of times bigger than man, but something like a man. When you say God the Son, I say, what are you thinking of? A prize bull or a false wagon? No, nothing like that. I say, handsome young man, blonde hair, blue eyes, handsome features, blue eyes, like what you saw in the King of Kings, I'm telling him. There's a film called King of Kings, Jesus. Day of Triumph, Jesus. Jesus of Nazareth, Jesus. You see, films. They have seen these films. So you think of him, in one of these, Jeffrey Hunter was acting. Jeffrey Hunter, you see, with blonde hair, blue eyes, you know, handsome features, straight nose, not with a poly nose, you know, humke te popat ya nak. Not with that, a straight nose like a German or like a Norwegian or a Swede or an Englishman, not like a Jew with a hooked nose. You know what Jesus looks like. Then when you say, and the Holy Ghost, I said, what are you thinking of? I said, the Holy Ghost, you read in the book, something that came like a dove, like kabutar from heaven in the shape of a dove. And when Jesus was baptized in the river Jordan by John the Baptist, or something that came in flames of fire at Pentecost. I said, the picture is not very vivid, but the picture is there. I said, you have three distinct mental pictures. The Father is different, the Son is different, and the Holy Ghost is different. He says, no. See, if the man is trying to be impossible, he can. He says, no. I said, look, do me a favor. Please close your eyes. And when I say, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost, honestly, I want you to tell me how many mental pictures you have. So when I pose the question, the children, school children, who are with him, with the family, mother, father and mother, they had school children. So the children thought they had the answer. It's so clear, so vivid. I said, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. I said, how many mental pictures have you got? So the children, they said, all together, three. And the mosque revibrated, echoed, you see, because it was empty at the time. Three, and if looks could kill, they all would have been dead. Because the parents didn't want to hear such words coming out from the children's mouth. And this was all God sent. So I'm telling them, I said, look, you know what Jesus said? He said, except ye be as one of these little ones, ye shall not enter the kingdom of God. I said, what did he want you to be? As silly as they are sometimes? As naughty as they are sometimes? No. Jesus said, you must be as simple and as sincere as they are. If the child sees three pictures, he'll tell you he sees three pictures. He's not afraid that he will get caught out or what not. He's honest. So I said, you see, now the child can see, but you can't because you don't want to admit. So it's a sickness. Allah tells us in clear-cut language in the Quran, وَلَا تَقُولُوا ثَلَاثَةً. Don't say Trinity. إِنْتَهُ خَيْرًا لَكُمْ. This is, stop it, it'll be better for you. إِنَّمَا اللَّهُ إِلَهُ وَاحِدٌ. For your Allah is one Allah, he's not three in one, and he's not one in three. And Jesus never taught this. It's not in his book. The word Trinity is not to be found in the Bible. The whole encyclopedia of 66 books, the word Trinity is not there. Amazing thing. The fundamental of their faith, that word itself is not there. But I said, you know what? That word is in the Quran. Amazing. The religion just says no Trinity. The word Trinity is in the Quran, but the Trinity is not in the Bible. But in the Quran, it says, وَلَا تَقُولُوا ثَلَاثَةً. Don't say Trinity. But the word Trinity is there in the Quran. The Bible even hasn't got that. I hope. You know, you get some of these tapes of mine, and it's continuously, these things are going on, you know, with the Christians coming along and posing questions, and we are answering. You can learn something. There was, at one time, one of my meetings, I went to the Cape Province. In South Africa, we have four provinces. Like Pakistan has four provinces. We have four provinces. So I was in one of these provinces, and I was lecturing at a place called Wynberg Town Hall in the Cape. And at question time, one white man, he came up questioning, and he was asking deep, searching questions. And every question I answered, he used that to develop another question. That answer, he developed another question. And from this questioning, I realized that he is no ordinary person. It's not easy that from an answer, you develop a question. From the answer again, you develop another question. So I whispered to the chairman, said, please ask the gentleman who he is. We'd like to know that he's asking such deep and searching questions. So the chairman asked, and he said, I'm Professor van der Merwe from the University of Stellenbosch, the headquarters of this Dutch Reformed Church institution, and I'm the professor of theology. Now we know his worth, you see, he's a great man, big man, the biggest man in the Stellenbosch University on theology. And after a few questions, a colored gentleman, colored is a mixture between black and white, you know, like you have Anglo-Indians, you call them here, a mixture between the Asiatic and the European, you call him Anglo-Indian. The African and white mixture, we call it colored. So there was a colored priest. He came up. He says, Mr. Didat, you people don't believe in the Holy Trinity, but what have you to say about the first epistle of John, chapter 5, verse 7, where it says, for there are three that bear record in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost, and these three are one. It's there in his book. He said, what about this? It's there in my Bible. Fortunately, Professor van der Merwe was there. So I got up to answer. I said, look, we are very, very fortunate that Professor van der Merwe is here with us today. So whatever I'm going to tell you, I'm not pulling a fast one on you. The professor will confirm whether I'm speaking the truth or not. I said, Professor, you see the verse he has quoted for the first epistle of John, chapter 5, verse 7. This is in the Roman Catholic version of the Bible. He said, yes. It is in the Authorized King James of the version of the Bible. He said, yes. But as is now taken out from all modern translation as a fabrication. As a fabrication, as an interpolation, as an adulteration. It's thrown out. It's not there anymore. Is it true? He said, yes. I said, you see, the reason is that this Trinity, in the ancient manuscript, this verse was not there. But a certain Vigilius of Thapsus in the 6th century, in his manuscript, he made a marginal note for his own edification, a marginal note in his own handwriting. But when they gave these manuscripts for reproduction, the marginal note became a part of the text. The words of a Vigilius of Thapsus, not the word of God, not the word of John, who's supposed to have written this epistle. So now your learned men realize that this is a fabrication, it's an interpolation, and they threw it out. Is it true? He said, yes. I said, thank you very much. So you see, now it depends now upon the type of knowledge, understanding this person you're talking to has. At times, you are talking to the wall. But even then, you can crack his skull, you know, with a few facts. Inshallah. Any other questions?
My name is Nuvera. I want to ask one question. We believe that the word of God delivered to Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam to Hazrat Jibreel alayhi salam. But how were the words were delivered to Hazrat Isa and Hazrat Musa alayhi salam to the same person? I mean, Farishta or who? I was confused, sir, so I wanted to ask this.
I think what I understand is this, that you'd like to know.
Yes.
That the revelation, the wahi, given to our Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam through Jibreel alaihi salam was given in word form.
Yes.
And